Leia here from leiaforsci.com/MCAT, and in this video, we'll take a look at pOH and pH calculations for weak bases. You can find this entire video series along with practice quiz and cheat sheet by visiting my website leiaforsci.com/MCAT Acid Base. Recall that a weak base is something that does not dissociate or does not react 100% in solution, which means that there will be an equilibrium. There will be a back and forth of reactants going to products and products back to reactants. A simple example to look at is ammonia, which will react with water to form ammonium and hydroxide. We have equilibrium arrows to show that the reaction is constantly going back and forth. So if we want to find something like a concentration or a pH, we have to take into account this equilibrium. To understand how you set this up for a base, let's look back at how you set up a KEQ or an equilibrium expression. You put the concentration of the products divided by the concentration of reactants. For this reaction, the products are ammonium and hydroxide, and the reactants are ammonia and water. But don't forget, for a KEQ expression, you can only have concentrations. Water is a liquid, and we don't include liquids or solids in a KEQ expression. That gives us ammonium, which is the protonated base. You can look at that as BH+. Hydroxide divided by ammonia, which is the starting base. The KEQ for a base dissociation can be thought of as a KEQ of base, or simply KB, where the KB expression is written out as protonated base, hydroxide, divided by your starting base. Let's take a look at this example. Find the pH of a 0.008 molar solution of NH3, given that the KB for NH3 is 1.8 times 10 to the minus 5. We're asked to find the pH, which is an acidic property, but we're given the KB of a base. So the first equation we have to keep in mind is that pH plus pOH is equal to pKW, which is equal to 14. Use the information given to find the pOH, and then use that to find the pH. When you cover this in Gen Chem, you were taught to write out the reaction and draw a detailed ice chart. That would give us NH3 plus H2O in equilibrium with NH4 plus and OH minus. We'll look for the initial, change, and equilibrium, and cross out water because we don't include concentrations for a liquid. The starting concentration of NH3 is 0.008. We'll assume that the concentrations for hydroxide are negligible and write zeros. Some quantity X will dissociate, so that some quantity X will form for ammonium and hydroxide, so that at equilibrium, my ammonia has a concentration of 0.008 minus X. Ammonium and hydroxide each have a concentration of X. And then we set it up so that KB is equal to ammonium and hydroxide divided by the molarity of ammonia, which is 0.008 minus X. All of that is equal to 1.8 times 10 to the minus 5, which is the KB. And then you turn this into a quadratic expression, wasted a good 10 minutes, and hopefully got the correct answer. Luckily, you have no calculators on the MCAT, and you can't solve it this way on the MCAT. Instead, you'll have to do some estimations. The first one is that given such a small dissociation value, we're talking about an average of 1 dissociation per 1 times 10 to the 5th undissociated molecules, so that if we subtract a tiny, tiny amount of X from 0.008, that's negligible. We're going to cancel that out, and when we cancel that out, we get a much more simplified expression. This is what you want to use instead. KB is equal to X squared over the molarity initial, and that you can solve without a calculator. So let's set this up. If KB is equal to X squared over the molarity initial, and we're looking for X because that'll give us the OH minus concentration, then we multiply both sides by the molarity initial to bring it to the top, and then we take the square root of both sides to isolate X. This gives me a new expression. X is equal to the square root of the molarity initial times the KB, which we'll plug in. The molarity initial is 0.008, And the KB is 1.8 times 10 to the minus 5. Now, how do we solve this quickly without a calculator? Let's run some estimations. 1.8 is approximately 2. So we have 2 times 8, which is 16. And now we have to account for the decimals. We have 10 to the minus 5, and this right here is to the minus 1, 2, 3. So we combine the two, negative 5 and negative 3 is negative 8, which gives me 16 times 10 to the minus 8. But this is not in proper scientific notation, so we'd have to fix it 1.6 times 10 to the minus 7. And the reason we did it that way is because we're doing the times 10 divided by 10 trick. 16 divided by 10 is 1.6. 10 to the minus 8 times 10 makes it one order of 10 bigger, which is minus 7, and that's the value we're looking at. The problem is, if we now want to take the square root, we do not have an even exponent. The shortcut for square roots of exponents is to divide it by 2 if it's an even number. So in a situation like this, look for a pattern. Right here we have an even exponent. Forget the proper scientific notation, this is so much easier to work with. Because we can break it down to say the square root of 16 is 4, the square root of 10 to the minus 8 is just half, that's 10 to the minus 4, and that means our OH minus concentration, which is equal to x, is equal to 4 times 10 to the minus 4. Now we want to use this to find the pOH, which is equal to negative log of the OH minus concentration, or negative log of 4 times 10 to the minus 4. If we want to find an estimate, we could say it's approximately 4, discounting that initial number. If we want to get a little more specific, the first thing we want to do is find if that pOH is slightly greater than 4 or slightly less than 4. And that means we have to find the closest unit of 10 next to it. 4 times 10 to the minus 4 doesn't let us do our perfect trick of 1 times 10 to the minus a power. So if we round it to the nearest ones, meaning we round it down to 1 times 10 to the minus 4, and we round it up to 10 times 10 to the minus 4, now we know which pOH values are slightly greater than or slightly less than our answer. 1 times 10 to the minus 4 gives me 4. 10 times 10 to the minus 4 is not in proper scientific notation. This is really equal to 1 times 10 to the minus 3, which gives me a pOH of 3. And that tells me that the pOH is somewhere between 3 and 4. If you want to take this a step further, you can think of the numbers you memorized for logs. If your number starts with a 3, you know that the negative log of that is going to be 0.5. If the number starts with a 5, you know the negative log is going to be 0.3. Since we have a 4, the answer is going to be somewhere between 3 and 5. 4 is a perfect in-between, and we need something between 3 and 4. So 3.4 is going to equal to our pOH. The 3, because that's between 3 and 4, and the 0.4, because 3 and 5 gives me 0.5 and 0.3, and the 4 is right in the middle. So we know our pOH is 3.4. 14 minus 3.4 equals our pH, and that is equal to 10.6. Let's try a slightly trickier example. This time, let's say we're given a 0.01 molar solution of ammonium chloride, and we're asked to find the pH. Once again, we're given that KB of ammonia is 1.8 times 10 to the minus 5. We're asked for a pH, we're given an acid, but the only value is a KB, which is a base. How do we calculate this from a base? The first thing you want to recognize is that a weak acid will be in equilibrium with its weak base. And the equilibrium here is NH4 plus, Cl minus is a spectator, we ignore it. It will react with OH minus to give me NH3 plus H2O. Given that this is a reaction at equilibrium, we can just as easily write the reverse reaction. NH3 plus H2O will be in equilibrium to give me NH4 plus OH minus. If we set it up this way, we can use the KB. But the problem is, our starting concentration is given for ammonia. So we have to find a way to calculate the Ka so that we can look at the acidic version of this reaction rather than the reverse basic version. And this is the equation to know. Ka times Kb is equal to Kw, which is equal to 1 times 10 to the minus 14 at 25 degrees Celsius. I want to prove this to you once so that you understand this, and then you'll have a much easier time remembering the memorized expression. The equation to know for Ka is that H plus times A minus is equal to HA. We're multiplying that by Kb, which is BH plus times OH minus divided by B for base. But this just looks like an entire mess. Nothing seems to relate to each other. And the problem with just memorizing is that you're not seeing the connection. BH plus is simply a protonated base. HA is a protonated conjugate base, so it's actually the same thing. And if one's in the numerator and one's in the denominator, they cancel. A minus is the deprotonated base. B is a base, meaning it's deprotonated, and once again, they cancel, leaving me with just H plus and OH minus. Now, isn't that the expression for Kw? Going back to our example, the first thing we want to do is find the Ka. So we have Ka times Kb is equal to Kw. Divide both sides by Kb, which gives me Ka is equal to 1 times 10 to the minus 14 divided by 1.8 times 10 to the minus 5. Round the 1.8 to a 2, so that 1 divided by 2 is equal to 0.5. Negative 14 divided by negative 5 is simply negative 14 minus negative 5, or negative 14 plus 5, which is equal to negative 9. And if we put this into proper scientific notation, we get 0.5 times 10, which is 5. 10 to the minus 9 divided by 10, which is minus 10. 5 times 10 to the minus 10. Now we're skipping the ice chart and jumping straight to the expression of Ka is equal to x squared over molarity initial, just like we did in the last video. Solve for x so that x is equal to the square root of Ka times molarity initial, and then we plug it in. X is equal to 5 times 10 to the minus 10 times the initial molarity of 0.01. 0.01, move the decimal twice to the right, that's multiplying by 100. 10 to the minus 10 has to be divided by 100, so we drop the exponent by 2, and that means x is equal to the square root of 5 times 10 to the minus 12. I don't know the square root of 5, but since 5 is very close to 4, we'll estimate and we'll say that it's approximately 2. 10 to the minus 12, divide that by 2, gives me times 10 to the minus 6, and that means our pH is equal to negative log of 2 times 10 to the minus 6. If you want to round it to 1 times 10 to the minus 6, your pH is going to equal to 6, but the MCAT is likely going to give you something slightly greater than 6 and something slightly less than 6, so you have to know which direction to go. Since our proton concentration is slightly more acidic than 1 times 10 to the minus 6, we want our pH to be slightly more acidic, and therefore we're looking for an answer slightly less than 6. If you have your log values memorized, you'll know that if it starts with a 2, you actually get a 0.7. What is a 0.7 slightly less than 6? 5.7. Just to show you how close we are, I punched this entire example into the calculator from the Kb to Ka conversion, and I got a final answer of 5.63 for my pH. Now, how close is that? Be sure to join me in the next video, where we look at calculations related to the autoionization of water. Are you stuck on a specific MCAT topic? I offer private online tutoring where I focus on your needs to strengthen your individual weaknesses. Tutoring details can be found using the link below or by visiting my website, leahforsci.com/MCAT tutor. Are you overwhelmed by the sheer volume of information required for the MCAT? Are you worried that lack of a proper study plan and low MCAT score will prevent you from getting into medical school? My new ebook, The MCAT Exam Strategy, a 6-week guide to crushing the MCAT, will help you formulate a concrete study plan by helping you figure out where you stand now, identify your goals, and figure out what it takes to reach them. And it's yours free when you sign up for my email newsletter at mcatexamstrategy.com.
By signing up for my email newsletter, you'll also be the first to know when I have new videos, MCAT study guides, cheat sheets, tips, and so much more. The link again, MCATExamStrategy.com.